राधे जय जय माधव जयते
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 एंड वी अंडरस्टैंड that Srimad Bhagavatam is the book tell about Krishna, non-divine from Krishna. Krishna means it includes Radharani. From Krishna's body Radharani is coming. So, this is to understand Krishna is very difficult. And to understand his chit potency, Radhini Shakti, it requires some qualification. So much so, to give an example, that even Srimad Bhagavatam, hardly his name is mentioned directly. Just covered way, it's little mentioned. Though Sukadeva Goswami himself is a highly elevated and liberated soul from birth within the womb. Considering this, the way Prabhupada said, we should remember this Radhani's appearance day in such a way that we should know where we spiritually stand, first of all. So spiritual life means one should go through four ashrams. Usually, one is brahmacharya, garastha, vanaprastha, sannyas. It's a gradual process. Brahmacharya means very early life, maybe at the age of 6 or so, doesn't matter, he is a prince, he has to go to Gurukul and like a menial servant, serve the Guru 24 hours and whatever he gets by serving, by begging and working day and night for the Guru, belongs to Guru. He addresses all women as mother, try to learn from then on. And thus, the time comes, his life is full of austerity and tapasya. And he can easily go back to God and easily go back. Then, according to Grihastha Ashram, Ashram implies spiritual life. And there is Grihastha Ashram, according to instruction of the Guru, he may take Grihastha Ashram if he is such, if Guru thinks he can carry on and take sannyas. Vanaprastha and sannyas, especially brahmachari and sannyas, all these are meant for practicing austerity for purity. So one has to become pure. Krishna is supremely pure to understand him. Pure means at least most of the time Prabhupada says, keep yourself in the mode of goodness. And grihastha, Brahmin, other side is one should be Brahminically qualified. That is why Prabhupada made this movement to have Brahmin, who means who knows he is not this body, he is spirit soul, which brahmacharya life helps to understand all these things, practice. Grihastha means he lives, and one of the important part of it is dan pratigya. He gives in charity to those who are renounced, especially brahmachari. And listen, Krishna katha more. For his Brahmin, he gets whatever donation or sannyasi, he is supposed to give it away, most of it, for the propagation of Krishna consciousness. Grihastha, of course, hold on to something. And this way, one elevates himself. Again, come to sannyasi, beyond that is Vaishnava Dharma. It says, among all living entities, very few are human beings. When you get the chance to transcend the material existence of birth, death, all those diseases, whether it is Brahma or Indra or insect or Asura, whatever. only those are pious, sinless, they start Krishna consciousness and become fixed up. So even we see the impersonalist go through tremendous austerity, lying on the floor for purification, take bath, even in severe cold 3 times, and many other things they do. They're full of austerity just to become pure, as he say, Lord, as Rishabdev, Nayam deho deho bhajam niloke kastan kaman birujam. Most of the people being in a mode of passion and ignorance, symptomized by too much hankering after possessing material assets and greedy, never satisfied, unlimited material desire, then he does little how to make economic development. For that he do perform devotional activity or spiritual life, then get frustrated, he want to get mukti. But the devotee is not like that, he is not after mukti. That is the goal of those who are monodharmi, that means jnani. He says real jnani is bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prabhate. One who is real jnani, that is devotee, he surrenders after many, many lives, speculation, austerity, to get free from this material existence or get mukti. And there are many types of mukti there. And from another angle, Prabhupada is judging that beyond kormi, jnani, even yogi, this is the devotee. That case is Prabhupada saying, among the living entity, human beings, very few. Among human beings, 8,400,000 species, very few are the follower of Vedic culture. And those who are say they follow Vedic culture, actually, most of them is lip service. They say I will follow Vedic culture, actually, they don't follow. They are like superficially. Follow this thing, not serious. Those who really follow, among them, some are kormi. Their number is maybe 98%, most of the people are kormi. Among millions of kormi, once become jnani, who understand I am not this body, and try to become free of the material existence, thinking always, any moment I am going to die. It's very serious. And yogi, but they are all mostly impersonal, try to merge with Brahma Jyoti, especially the jnani. Because they are abhishuddha buddha, their intelligence is not pure, they fall down usually from Brahma Jyoti, because being feeling monotony or bored, no variegatedness, that is Krishna consciousness. That out of many, many jnani, maybe millions, one become liberated. And then among the many, many liberated person, koti-shopi millions, one becomes really a pure devotee. That is said in another place, Krishna Bhagavad Gita, manushyanam sahasresu. According to Samapara Acharya, Madhvacharya said, manushya is he who at least brahminically qualified, he can be called manushya. Otherwise, most of them are, as Rishabdev said, working day and night, work hard. For what? Enhancing sense gratification. That is, hawks, dogs are also doing. So material advancement means hawks, dogs civilization, but polished, nice dress, nice dog. Nice material advancement of scientific so-called, that is, that they cannot understand, it is not meant for them. So he is telling Rishabh Dev Lord to even not this age, we are very fallen. Manda, Sumanda Mateo, Manda Bhagga, Hipodhuta. But those are little pious, little sinless. By the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he made it very simple. Otherwise, Rishabh Dev said to his son, who is eldest of them is Bharat, Tapo Dibbam Putraka. Why do tapasya? Jeno Satta Suddhaya. In order to purify your existence, do tapasya. Otherwise, Satta Jivahaya. Everybody has a mode of goodness and hongsa, more or less, you know, very good devotee, even if it is a prostitute. He said, at that age, people used to live, because of their piety so much, used to live 100,000 years. But it is difficult to understand God, realize self. Then people become little degraded, not so pure. Lord Ramchandra understand. Still, Teta Yuga, they are living 10,000 years because they are pure, much pure than us. But it's still difficult to realize God at that time. He used to do yoga. And it cost a lot of money, only royal families can do. You got so much gold, so much grain, so much butter clarified to do in the fire sacrifice and pay the Brahmins. Then become Dapar Yuga. The people used to live only 1,000 years. And the process of realizing self of God realization was going to the temple, all these things, and pray with deities, worshipping, you know. And then Kali Yuga, people are so fallen, they live maximum maybe 100 years. And time will come, they will live maybe 20, 25 years, maybe enough. And we will hardly find, because of the material nature, we withdraw the basic necessities of life or food grains. There may not be any grains, there may not be any sugar, there may not be any milk. And vegetables, fruits also won't be that much. Trees will be all full of thorns. But still we are fortunate. So Lord Chaitanya came. They were impersonalist. They don't accept deity. They simply do austerity, basically, to purify themselves. And ultimately end up with everything is either void, sunnavadi, or some light or force, something like that, impersonal. But the devotees are fortunate. The Lord came, though he is one, just to, the devotees feel, just to enjoy, he becomes two, Radha, Krishna. Potent and potency, energetic and energy. This is called tattva vichar. One has to know God through tattvata, as it says. Vadanti tattva tattva vidas tattam jat jnanam adyayam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaneti shabdate. That they can understand God, this feature. They can understand God. They are brahmagyani. Brahmagyani. Brahmabhuta prasannatma na sochati na kankra. Sama sarveshu bhuteshu mad bhakti lavatva. This is real bhakti starts. Otherwise, what we are doing is vidhi bhakti. We want to know Radharani, all these things, better be qualified. Otherwise, we will be doing vidhi bhakti. I have seen Krishna last night, our sahajya. They think Radha, Krishna, like man, young boy, girls, they are loving affairs in this material world. It is based on this body. But very fast lesson is spiritual life, is we are not this body. It doesn't matter, you are impersonalist. So we are there. Long way to go to qualify, but you can have a little bit knowing so that you can have a desire to one day develop spontaneous love for Krishna. And by the mercy personified Krishna's Radharani, who is very soft-hearted and very broad-minded, if we are pure and strictly follow, we can pray to her today. Today is the most auspicious day of his appearance day. And so, Sanak Sanatan, they told about them, though they are perfect brahmachari, looks like little poor boys, kids, but actually they are very old. They are perfect brahmachari. At Kali Yuga, to find perfect brahmachari is very difficult. Most of us, most probably, didn't go through brahmachari life. And our brahmachari school also seems like it didn't work well. But we have got hope. By the mercy of pure devotee Prabhupada. Doesn't matter, we are just the home and sweeping floor of Krishna's temple, we can become pure by Chetu Darpana Marjanam, by chanting Krishna's name. So it is said, Pravi Sankutani Jagu Jajanti Sumedasa. One who has got brain substance, not cow dung, not hawks and dogs life living. He can understand simply by chanting, praying to dear Radharani, dear Krishna, please engage me in your service. If we give up our aparad and become purified, taking prasad only, not going outside, very palatable thing, taking, there is quite good chance. Otherwise, Prabhupada won't tell Jayananda Prabhu that I think this life has gone back to Godhead and joined with Krishna. If not, most probably he go to very higher planets. And they are, whatever he is lacking in Krishna consciousness, he is completing. And go back to Godhead. Our purpose is, we should see how whatever you are doing is pleasing Krishna. Atap pumbhi dijas sista, varnasama vibhagas, sang stirista samasya, sang siddhi hoitosanam. That is why you are doing this sankirtan yoga, Kali Yuga. Not other yoga. It's only yoga is Sankirtan. Yoga avai Vishnu. Purpose of whatever you are doing, is it to please Krishna or please my tongue or other organs? That you can ask little introspective. If it is to please Krishna, we can also to some extent please ourselves. What Krishna wants, we give it to him and take the prasad and purify. So you say, Mahaprasade Govinde. Now, Sarira Abhidya Jala, I am not this body. Jarendriya Tahika, these material senses are like very poisonous snake, like death personified. But if we use it in Krishna service, then fangs, the teeth, the kala, like snake, poisonous, take it out, then snake cannot do anything. So if we engage our all senses for the pleasure of Krishna, that is bhakti. Sarva padhi vinid muktam. Give up all false ego. I am this, I am that. You have to qualify. Just we are sitting, now dressing, sannyasi. Somebody asks, I must tell the truth. I don't qualify to be a sannyasi. What I know, what sannyasi, what to speak of that, may not be even brahmachari, what true brahmachari means. So let us be honest and frank and tell what is what and try for it. So, it is said, Vedaishya Sarvai Ahameva Veda. Purpose of all Veda is to understand Krishna. It is not easy. Krishna himself is saying, Tad Vidhi Pranipatena. That means, Prakrusha Nipatita. You surrender to some person. Serve him, Puriprasnena Sevaya. And serve him, your devotee, Prabhupada, or Acharya Dinde. Then you can ask questions, not in a challenging mood. Then, one is tattva-vid, he knows the tattva, brahmeti, paramatmeti, bhagavaneti. One knows Bhagavan, he automatically knows Brahma and Paramatma. Asking, serving, then if he is pleased, jasya prasadat, bhagavat prasadat. If you take him as he is almost as good as God, respect him, treat him like that, without committing offense, then there is chance. I don't know how many of us think like that. Of course, somebody may be thinking. And if he is pleased, then Krishna is pleased. And he can pray. Exactly. If Radharani is pleased without prayer, then Radharani can recommend Krishna. Here is a devotee. I am not devotee. here is your devotee, he brought nice flowers for you, he did decoration for you, please accept his service. Vishnu is like that. Then it's a jiji, Baba said. Then it's a jiji. Then it's not difficult. May not be that much pure. But at least that much pure as Radharani expect. So Chana Prasanatan says, our songs are there. And Prabhupada is saying, that's why Krishna is saying, Sarva Dharman Purittaja Mame Kong Saranam Bhaja. Not other demigods. Even not Shiva Brahma. You can respect them. Moment we think Shiva Brahma, these are also Bhagavan, these are also Bhagavan. Now impersonalist. Telling Bhagavan, famous person. Where you look for Bhagavan? Everybody is Bhagavan. Why are you looking for Bhagavan? Why you see everywhere? These are all Bhagavan. My Bhagavan, very funny. No significance. Addressing each other as Om Namo Narayana. You become Narayana, you become Sannyas. We don't see. Narayana has got four hands. Even he has no four hands. What to speak of Narayana's quality? He has got all the six opulences, nothing here. And make him Narayan, beggar, Doridra Narayan. Doctor is Narayan, patient is Narayan, everything is Narayan. Makes a chief. Even United Nations, they write about Vaishnava. Radha Krishna Gopi, the chief like any man, woman's young boys and girls. This is there, many. Overnight becoming dressing like a Paramahansa, take it very easy. Reading Ujjal Nilimani, Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi. When you do that, but still he has got lusty desire. He is the mood of passion and ignorance. And he found to be reading all those things, reading dressing like a Paramahansa, but after reading this thing, time to time going, this is Paramahansa, Kali Yuga. And like Radha Krishna, he has got many also ladies to serve him. He left his wife, he came here and every man serving. This is Kali Yuga Paramahansa. Paramahansa means actually topmost sannyasi. Prabhupada expect our Grihastha to be Goswami. If not Paramahansa, at least Goswami, controlling the senses, using the senses in the service of Krishna, bring out children to become Vaishnava or Vaishnava. I don't want to say what you expect from the sannyasi. What do you expect? Who has become topmost Vaishnava? He will be the Prabhupada made a body. He is supposed to be topmost authority. Everybody should be topmost Vaishnava. That he expected. When I asked this thing to one topmost bodies, authorities, what is the qualification? He said, oh, Subha, Prabhupada said he should be topmost Vaishnava. So this way we can ask ourselves how pure and qualified we are to know all these things. So what Prabhupada said, I am little saying. So, Prabhupada mostly told about Krishna, the first know Krishna. And to know Krishna tattat, only bhakta can, Vaishnava can. And who is a Vaishnava? In short, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, Kanako Kameni Pratishtha Bhagin. One who is not aspire for all these things. Kanako, meaning after wealth. Kameni, in aspiring, enjoy opposite gender association. Pratishtha, hankering after big position, profit, adoration, distinction. People worship me. It's difficult, no? So this is thing and says, and Prabhupada, when we joined early days, I remember, I'm talking about, I joined, going to 69, 70. Maybe initiated 71, UK. So, we understand, when early days Prabhupada started this movement, we went to 65, and Prabhupada said, actually speaking, 68 movement started. So he's saying, and following strictly. And so, although he registered 65 or 66, Krishna consciousness. He said, you want to become a Vaishnava, remember this. These are, according to Chaitanya Devanta, 28 qualifications. And every night, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, once every night, once every Ekadashi, ask yourself how you are, you know, qualifying yourself. This thing you don't endeavor to become. Automatically, if you render pure devotional service, you manifest all these qualities of Vaishnava, 28. As Krishna said, Uddhava also. And then you know, you don't have to become a sannyasi, neither other positions, distinct. Even Brahmin, you qualify all the Brahminical quality, only Vaishnava, it's okay. It's beyond sannyasi. Like that. First you ask yourself how much you are describing. So he, that's why he said, how to understand Krishna. So it's manushyanam sahasreshu. Out of thousands of men, sahasra means thousands, million. Kuschit dasdi, few try to achieve perfection. Few means liberate or get siddhi. And Krishna has got all the siddhis. You know, some of the siddhis, you know, this doing thousands of years tapasya, Vishwamitra says, become victim of Menaka. Because seeing he is so much austerity means get tremendous power. Thus one try to become God. And people tell them like that. You can make little something, dust into gold dust. He is God. And like that, there are many gods there. The God becoming very cheap now. So, Prabhupada said, don't accept them. They are not God, they are dog. And one who is like a, living in a hogs and dog civilization, he is far away from all this thing, knowing what to speak of. Knowing rather than knowing Krishna is even difficult. So how to know Krishna? Among those who are siddha, among many, many of them, one can, maybe one or two, can know Krishna factually, tattata, as he is. So it is not easy to understand Krishna. Even Vishwamitra becoming, Vishwamitra became victim. And then in this path also it is very difficult, Maya is very strong. Many, even making so much advancement, suddenly become victim of Maya. Even the Rishi Jaimini, who composed one of the, compiled one of the Veda, he one day was bragging. When Vedavyasa says something, his guru, he just laughed at him. He said, Maya is nothing. But Vedavyasa then tested him. He again became victim, he said. He is not free from the attraction, material nature. So what to speak of us? So understand Krishna, it is not so easy. So understand, a great personality, he has got many, he doesn't do anything. He has got many assistants. So Krishna also has got unlimited number of expansion to do his work. When Krishna is killing Asura, it is not original Krishna is doing. Original Krishna simply enjoys. Simply plays his flute and he has got his expansion, pleasure potency's expansion. Radharani, gopis, cowherd boys, Mother Yashoda, all these things, he give them pleasure, they also give him pleasure. And that is spiritual thing, not material bliss. He is the embodiment of eternity, bliss and knowledge. These are nothing but his shakti. And these are little high, so I am not going into detail this anything, because it's all theoretical. You don't have practically all these things. So when from Tamagun and Rajagun, we become free to come to at least mode of goodness, Prabhupada said. Then come to pure goodness, with goodness start doing devotional service. And pure goodness, understand what God is. That is called Vasudev Satya. Or Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur mentioned, ask yourself, when Krishna was born, before that Balaram came. Because when Krishna comes, you cannot ask Krishna, sit here. Just a prophecy. When king comes, you cannot ask any seat to sit him. What to speak of Krishna? When Krishna comes before that, within our heart Krishna is there, but it is not manifesting, we are not realizing. Why? Full of dirty things there. First dirty thing is deeply rooted, the bodily concept. I am Indian, I am man, I am Brahmin, I am Sannyasi. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Naham Vipro, I am not a Brahmin, I am not Grihastha Brahmachari Sannyasi Jyoti, I am nothing, all these things. I am servant of the servant of the servant many times, at the topmost devotee of Krishna. So when you come to that state, give up all this falsehood, which is very difficult to give up. We expect. So Prabhupada, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to crush the pride. One should be free from pride. Pride of those who are renounced. He was asking questions to a Grihastha. Not only that, he is a Shudra. Not only that, he is a king, a politician, an administrative position. They are not supposed to. They are supposed to be inferior to a sannyasi. And he is asking question. Asking. He doesn't have to ask question. Why did he ask? To teach us, they learn Krishna consciousness from a Vaishnava. Doesn't matter he is a Grihastha, Brahmachari, sannyasi, or nothing of that. Cast their pride. Naturally their pride. And so, when Krishna will come, in the womb of Devaki, from Vasudev, first he asked Yogamaya that my expansion, Ananta says, is coming. You transfer him from the womb of Devaki to womb of Rohini. Yes? If I am wrong, please correct. I admit. Rohini. And why Balaram? Krishna's first expansion is Balaram. Why Balaram? The Balaram represents his what he uses, his clothes, his asan, his karam, his slipper, his bed. That is Ananta says. Yes? So he came. And before that, there are six other son was born, Devaki. Yes? And they are killed by Krishna. According to Vishnath Chakravarti Thakur, our Acharya, he said, it means when all these things are destroyed, you become free from this. What are these? Your dirty things in your heart, lust, desire, calm, crodh, anger, lobe, greediness, moha, illusion, mod, pride, arrogance, jealousy and enviousness. It takes time. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Cheto Darpana Marjana, cleanse your consciousness. Forget you are Indian, Pakistani, American, Chinese, Russian. Bhava Mahadabhagnindam, then this material life is always feeling anxiety, tension, danger. No, you become peaceful. That is gone. We can go through this first sloka. Mahanidhirvam, Sras Kaidava Chandrikavita, like the soothing moonlight, like that your life becomes, like the relish life. Vidya Bodhum, you get real knowledge, spiritual knowledge. Jivana, it becomes your life and soul. Anandam Buddhivardham, Sarvatmas, when you completely surrender, Anandam Buddhivardhanam, you enjoy, you find yourself in an ocean of bliss, and it go on increasing. But material bliss we get, going to Prabhupada say, what is this? It is Prabhupada music coming from a band. Why? And they are selling to attract the children. What they attract for? He is selling ice cream, 25 types of. Prabhupada, hey, it's Maya. And Prabhupada everybody likes. Anyway, he is calling you, come, come, come. It's like a fish. And there is bite there, you know, so many things, smelly, and fish. Come here, eat me. I will take you up, pick you up, and then I will eat you. Prabhupada said, this is our case. So, we have to purify ourselves. And impersonally doing austerity, it is not necessary for us. It will make our heart strong. stone. Her heart will be soft. That's why he says, Tinadra Pishunichena. Tolu Riva Sahishna. Tolai. When you go to distribute book, how much you have to tolai it? I know. Sometimes somebody has sponge. Somebody spat it on his face. Devotee tolai it. Devotee tolai it. Take the risk. One devotee says, I have to go. Oh, but I will see you after 5 years. Why? I have to go to confinement. Me and my friend. How many years? 5 years. Okay, do something. He gave, make them some cloth, make into small, small knot so they can chant Hare Krishna. Don't mind, Vasudev Devaki also suffered. In order to have Krishna, they are in confinement, jail of Krishna, Kamsa. Nothing wrong. Go, 5 years later, come. Doesn't matter. He chant Krishna, we'll take care of you. It was not 5 years. It was 5 years according to law. What they did. But 5 years they didn't have to pass. Neither 1 year. Neither 1 month. Within 27 days when they are chanting, Krishna arranged and they are released. And they come back to Prabhupada. Yeah? We are here? Yes, they asked us to go. They found something wrong in the case, in some flaw. And my lawyer showed it and they said, okay, in that case, don't have to. You can go. 27 days. Not even 1 month. This is called Krishna consciousness. Those are long time in the movement, they must have experienced many things, whatever you are desiring. Krishna fulfills. Take care if you want to serve. Anybody? 8, 10 years, they know how Krishna helps. God helps those who help themselves. So we want to become pure, to understand Krishna. Krishna will help. Prabhupada is there. You follow Prabhupada, so read my books. But still many of us drifted away. Maybe now I ask somebody, my God brother soul, maybe Mukunda Maharaj. I was with many of them, Mukunda Maharaj, Hansa Dutta, many others, Sam Sundar, old Prabhupada's devotee, first man, many others, others, Maluti. So we understand that now maybe what Prabhupada started with 10,000 devotees, maybe 5,000 are initiated. And there are 5,000 to be. I don't know, I heard presently, maybe 5% is among them there. Of course, many of them are going away, expiring, disappearing. There are many drifted away to many others. So we can see how everybody is tested. Of course, there of them, all of them will come back. It's just a matter of time. Because my is so strong. We cannot tell when you till the end. Again, last moment, remember Krishna. Just a few days ago, I was watching how one of my godbrother, whom I was talking in Vrindavan, I spoke was the moment you hear your days are numbered. The doctor, he may have cancer or something, just like Jayananda had. Better go back to your dham, Vrindavan, Mayapur, Jagannathpur, and be completely absorbed in Krishna consciousness. Go every day to the temple, chant, dance, take only prasad, be careful, don't do any offense, commit any offense. Then more you can be assured, maybe one life you can make it. So I was watching a few days ago, his Maharaj, Gunagrahi, he did a lot of service in his time. Many big devotees came, some of them might have gone now, passed away or drifted away. And they did a lot of service. And he was doing India Fest when I saw him first in America. So I was talking to him when he was there, and Maharaj liked it very much. And if he could do some service to Maharaj. And one of my godbrothers, few, Burijan Prabhu, Radhanath Swami, Rita Dhat Swami, Bhakti Bhinga Govinda Maharaj was there near his bed. I was talking to them and asked me, Shubhak sent some message. There will be when he left, Gopal Krishna Maharaj came when he was put in Samadhi. And Bhakti Bhinga Govinda was, he was finding very painful. Before he leaves his body, he has cancer. He told me, Subhag, you have got to be careful, do not have cancer. I have no control over it. I have got also the same prostate problem after 60. I am now almost coming to 80 years old. Just minus 80, little 77, 78. Right. Just that he is talking to me before. Yeah. Subhag, very painful, Subhag. Anyway, the Bhakti Govinda Maharaj went and he could not speak. They are all chanting, many other devotees, Hare Krishna. Doctor says, it won't be long, very time, maybe some more minutes, something. They are all chanting, chanting. Now he spoke to his ear nicely. He sometimes do Kirtan Mela, this Sachinandan Swami, this Bhakti Govinda lead sometimes. Very nice tune and melody. He was whispering through his ears, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Then, with great difficulty, he chanted, Hare Krishna, and left his body. You can learn from this. Leave your last time before you leave your body. You can go to lotus feet of Radharani in this material world, Vrindavan, in hospice. He is showing many tribes. We don't know we have got this. Prabhupada sometimes will say, Prabhupada himself also did, sometimes will say, I sometimes like rather to die in the battlefield, go on preaching. And then you are with Krishna. Krishna, yeah, he's very dear. And if don't, cannot, let us go back to Mayapur, Vrindavan, or Jagannath Puri, any of the places, Krishna's pastimes, preferably this thing. And Maharaj made it. He did so much service. I saw him in 1990 when I went to States first. And he was doing India Fest, big party, traveling across America. So I was talking to Maharaj all these things. You did so much, so Krishna gave you opportunity to come to Vrindavan. I hope I can do it. But I couldn't. I was almost going few times, living body anywhere outside Vrindavan. But planning always, how to spend my rest of the days, I am becoming old, to three dham, Mayapur, Vrindavan, Jagannath Puri, divide my time. And here is my Maharaj, so fortunate. You pray, now today is the day, Radharani is. One of the song, the Vrajavasis always chant Radhe Radhe, because Radharani is mercy, you can easily get the mercy of Krishna, right? If Radharani comments, she is very merciful. Yeah. So to get our Jiva Goswami, top philosopher say, even what a speak of us, there is too much austerity, just to have a little bit Brahman pleasure, they are doing so much austerity, tapasya. We don't have to do all this thing. We simply try to follow pure devotional service and try to please Radharani. Today we can pray, all of us. So one of the prayer is, this is Radharani's glorification. Radhe jaya jaya madhava doite gokula tarani mandala mohite damodara roti vardhana veshe hori niskuta bindabipineshe vishuhanu dodhi navashashi leke lalita sukhi guna mita vishakhi. This is a vandana prayer to Radharani. We can do today. Karuna kurumahi karuna bhrite. You are the mercy, compassion personified embodiment of Krishna. So it is very easy, because sanak sanatan, it is said that when you are glorifying you. So oh dear to Hari, to please increase the pleasure of Krishna, you dress yourself very nicely, and everybody that is why glorify you, all glories to you. And you dress yourself nicely and please the darling of Nanda Maharaj in Vrindavan. You are the queen of Vrindavan. You appeared from the ocean of Vishwahanu, King Vishwahanu. You are like the moon. You are dear to Lalita and for friendship, compassion, and in favor of Krishna, glorifying him. Even you control Vishakha, who is also a great devotee. But ultimately, we are full of compassion. So today, please be merciful to me. We should be praying to Radharani. So Radharani recommends, she is very merciful and soft-hearted lady. We should consider that in material world, man woman relation like that, Krishna, Radharani. In the spiritual world, somebody goes, there is also man woman there, husband wife there, but they so much like to serve Krishna in the mood of Radharani that they don't feel all these things, bodily attraction. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed, in order to understand Krishna, Radharani, this very intricate subject, Prabhupada said, philosophy, very high. Krishna comes in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to teach us how to feel separation from Krishna and thus understand Krishna, which the Goswamis did. Gave up their top position, gave up their luxurious life, association with top persons of this aristocratic society, all their wealth, and 24 hours forgetting and conquering, eating, sleeping. After 2 days, Raghunath Das Goswami taking little bit of buttermilk, or Rup Sanatan, one or two chapati with little dry chana, chippies, that is also without salt, whatever they get. Living under each tree, but feeling that desire is fulfilled, whatever the desire spiritually. Because spiritual world or spiritual plane means whatever you desire to fulfill. In our case, those are long time in the movement, you must have experienced that. May not be at once fulfilled, but at least many of our desire, spiritual desire, hankering after Krishna's service and us rendering pure devotion service to Radharani. Radharani is very kind hearted. Today is the best day to ask, and she gave chance to do service for her pleasure. And giving her nice preparation, what she likes, and cook for Krishna, and Krishna and Radharani can enjoy, and we enjoy by giving them enjoyment. That we can share it, and make our life sublime, and one day understand Krishna, one day understand Radharani by their grace, and join with them as Prabhupada in Kumbh Mela, he was chanting Jai Radha Madhava. And suddenly he stopped, his voice choked up, tears came up. So after 5 minutes, he said, never mind, chant Jai Radha Madhava. And when devotee asked him, he said, Prabhupada, if you mean ask you some question, yes, anything spiritual, yes. So we find, you are chanting Jai Radha Madhava, and stopped, couldn't say anything. Prabhupada said that he expressed, the song we are singing, exactly all these things happening you can experience. You qualify yourself. Even in this material world, come to the spiritual plane, by the mercy of Radha and Krishna, they can manifest to you all these things past time, so you can be greedy to go back. Now we are reading what Prabhupada is saying. If you want to join with Krishna, join with Mother Yashoda, join with Siddham Sudham Vasudham, Nanda Maharaj, and the gopis, we should qualify ourselves. First Prabhupada said, first desire, then desire. So I just repeat what Prabhupada said, though we are not qualified, you bless, so you can become qualified. And zealous Krishna consciousness, sweetness of Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna, thank you very much. There are 5-6 minutes there. Any comment or discussion? Hare Bhagavan. Jai Shri Prabhu. You want to say anything? We are long time in the movement.
I was thinking, you said that you are now 77. I was thinking how young you still appear.
By the mercy of the Vaishnava Vaishnavi, I think. By the mercy of so many Vaishnava Vaishnavi. Yeah. learning from them how to stay. But I must say, small, small fall down must be there. I'm not coming to Mangala Arati nowadays. Today I came. They asked me, Maharaj, can you come? And I said, okay, try. Made it. Usually I see in the internet, rather do my job or more read. Difficult to control tongue. So I am dressing like a sannyasi, I must tell. Eating nice cream, so many other things. They are doing gulab jam. But if you are attached to gulab jam, maybe come to here, not go to there. I think. This is my, to be honest, one can control all this. So I am supposed to, as you are dressing, and people giving, showing respect, do not deserve. I should return it to Prabhupada, all these things, respect on behalf of him, accept. Anybody, anything? So that we don't become sahaja. When you try to jump into this, without become free from the heart disease, lusty desire. Now if we ask ourselves here, those who are sitting, who can say, I am free from the attraction of the material nature, which is formidable according to even Rukmini talking to Krishna. The material nature, who can say, who is the king? I think these three modes of material nature is the king. Who is not controlled by them? Anybody here? Devika. We are not completely surrendered. Trying to, at least, to be honest. And can say, free from the sense object, attraction. If somebody says, Maharaj, outside, hot pizza. Supposed to fast till 12. Kala Sambhava told me, so Maharaj, tomorrow is fasting. Yes? I said, I don't know, this fasting tomorrow. He said, Radhani, please, Shiva Maharaj. Okay, I'm trying. I have got gastric ulcer. Doesn't matter. Concession. I'm taking a little ginger tea in the morning. Keep myself warm so that I can come. Put some petrol in my engine. Excuse me, tell the truth, be honest. I got it. Maybe you are doing, in that way you are doing good. I feel. So today we should all pray to Radhani feelingly, so that he shall mercy and recommend to Krishna. Recommend us to Krishna. Krishna, here is, he is doing something for you. Please accept. Then Krishna will accept. And Radhani is very kind. He is sincerely serving, working so hard, so nice, looking wonderful inside. Early in morning when a Mangala Arati I am seeing, look like Vrindavan. Birds, flowers, simple living. That is Vrindavan. All great devotees, birds, trees, swan, peacocks. Great devotees. Even Vrindavan, those who are in the shantaras or trees, rivers, they are also eager to serve Krishna. So Prabhupada say, ISKCON means service attitude. Everybody should be serving. We have a submissive under somebody. Because you become Trinadu Vishunicham. Become Sahishnu, distributing book. Give all respect to others. And then chant Hare Krishna. You should put a locket. Krishna Das Kaviraj is a maybe Supreme Paramahamsa. He is teaching Raga Marga, Chaitanya Chaitanya Mitra. He is so humble, he is teaching us or he's saying how low he is. He's, I am lower than Jagai Madhai, lower than mom in the refuse of our body. You can think of what he's saying. For us, lip service is very easy. Tell like this. But we should meditate on that, I think. How much we are like that. We are getting so much respect, profit, adoration, worshipping. Because our position, designation is difficult. These things are also irresistible. Like asking pizza, whatever we call. We take it sometimes for granted, all these things. And then pay high price, they come to our senses. Better late than never. Be humble. Like Jayananda Prabhu. In church they are looking for, they found him. He is doing most menial service. Early days. He was cleaning all garbage, everything. So, you are in charge? Yes. So what? Oh, I see. Mr. Prabhupada said also, Vaishnava means, leader means, from the menial service, the topmost service he can do. If nobody there, he will do. Gladly, because it's service to Krishna, service to Radharani, everything. Doesn't matter, cleaning the temple or cleaning even bathroom, toilet. Serving the Vaishnava. But sometimes, what? I am this. What do you expect me to do? Sometimes, our false ego get carried away by the false ego. That is the qualification. I hope I am taking much time. It's a little over 7. Huh? 15 more minutes. 8:15 is what? They will open. But I dare not say more than this. I take permission of Prabhupada and then tell this. I know I should not tell all this. I am just repeating what Prabhupada said. Prabhupada said, tell this and qualify yourself. I am not qualified. Yes. Giving signal. Finished. 5 minutes more.
20 minutes.
Yeah, I thought that before also. When you told, I thought, you can't make it. Neither I can make. Tell more. I have no eligibility, qualification to tell more about this. Better we now pray to Radharani from now on through Prabhupada, then go to Radharani and get the blessing of Prabhupada and Radharani, and then ultimately Krishna. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much for giving time.